I'm a ventriloquist dummy. That's all I am. Because every string Scythe pulls, I obey. My limbs go in the direction of need, not want. The words aren't only written in screens, but in thoughts. I swallow them. I hold them in. Every syllable carves a new wound, but that's not what they see. They see bright teeth and laughs. They see happy. If only they could stare through my eyes, just a second longer. Maybe they'll see how every night I lie in bed and beg my ribs to stick out, the fat on my stomach to disappear, my nose to be smaller, my legs to not jiggle. I want to be a lot of things, and none of them are me. When I step on the scale, I'm never happy. The pounds go down, the depression goes up. That's where I'd like to be. I want to be so light that I float into the air like a flower. Delicate, but not fragile. Soft somehow. A perfect little girl would crap the media cells. And I believe it. I'm living, almost not breathing proof of it. The model, Kate Moss, once said, "Nothing tastes as good as skinny feels." That's not true. While food tastes good, skinny feels like starvation when it's done wrong. Feels like a hollow rock that could crack. Skinny to me feels like shaking legs and protruding bones, like headaches and stale vomit. I really hate how skinny feels. All I do is wait for the mirror to repay that hatred, but it never does, because it'll never be enough. 100 will turn to 90, to 80, to 70, to gone. The only number able to bring about joy is 0. Oblivion. But damn it, I don't want oblivion. I want hugs and friends. I want family and pets, and you know what? I want pizza too. Who the hell cares if my thighs touch? Who the hell cares if I don't look like the girls in the magazines? The girls in the magazines don't even look like the girls in the magazines. Maybe this is a transition I needed to make. And maybe, no, definitely, it can get better from here.